In this video, you'll learn about the impact of external debt to an economy. Also, you'll get an overview of the role of the International Monetary Fund, or the IMF, and the World Bank, and start to see how they impact global trade and economic development. A country's external debt is a debt it owes to foreign lenders. The more a country owes to others, the more it has to repay in debt servicing. Debt servicing is the process of paying back a debt over a period of time and includes both principal and interest payments on loans. So a government would have to carefully consider the opportunity cost of its borrowing and spending. LEDCs, or less economically developed countries, can rack up significant debts from external sources such as foreign governments or multilateral institutions. As a country finds it increasingly more difficult to repay their debts, they are faced with difficult choices to make. They may have to choose between cutting government spending on healthcare, education, or infrastructure in order to service the debt. Alternatively, they could default on their debts, but this decision will have a harmful effect on future borrowing and also strains relations between the lending and borrowing countries. So now this leads us into an overview of the role of the International Monetary Fund and the World Bank. The IMF and the World Bank were created in 1944 at Bretton Woods in response to the devastation of World War II, with the aim of improving long-term development and to strengthen economic order and international cooperation. Today, both organizations aim to improve the standard of living of their member countries. Let's take a look at how they do this. The following explanation of the IMF's role is taken from the article, The IMF at a Glance, available on the IMF website as referenced below the image and in the video notes. The International Monetary Fund, or IMF, promotes international financial stability and monetary cooperation. It also facilitates international trade, promotes employment and sustainable economic growth, and helps to reduce global poverty. The IMF is governed by and accountable to its 190 member countries. Also referenced from the same source, the primary aims of the IMF are to promote international monetary cooperation, facilitate the expansion and balanced growth of international trade, promote exchange stability, assist in the establishment of a multilateral system of payments, and make resources available with adequate safeguards to members experience balance of payments difficulties. Next, we'll simplify what the IMF does by focusing on three different areas. The three key focus areas of the IMF include, first, surveillance, by monitoring member country policies and seeking out potential risks and suggesting policy adjustments. Second, offering financial assistance to countries experiencing balance of payments problems. Third, capacity development through technical assistance and training to aid member countries develop their economic institutions and improve human capital. This could involve fiscal, monetary, or exchange rate policies, regulation, legal frameworks, and data collection and analysis. It's also important to note that loans from the IMF are not without conditions. Governments must meet the requirements of the IMF, which could include structural or economic policy changes. Now, let's take a look at the World Bank. The World Bank mission is to accomplish two things. First, to end extreme poverty by reducing the share of the global population that lives in extreme poverty to 3%. Two, to promote shared prosperity by increasing the incomes of the poorest 40% of people in every country. The World Bank aims to accomplish these goals through long-term lending and technical assistance to lower and middle-income countries to assist in their long-term economic development. The focus of the support is generally on health, education, access to clean water and electricity, and environmental protection. The World Bank provides this support and assistance through its five organizations: the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, which lends to governments of low-income and middle-income countries; the International Development Association provides interest-free loans and grants to governments of the poorest countries; the International Finance Corporation focuses on the private sector by financing investment, mobilizing capital in international financial markets, and providing advisory services to businesses and governments. The Multilateral Investment Guarantee Agency offers political risk insurance to investors and lenders to developing countries. And the International Center for Settlement and Investment Disputes, which provides international facilities for conciliation and arbitration of investment disputes. So by now you should have a better understanding of the role of external debt. on an economy, as well as a general idea of the roles of the IMF and the World Bank. If you have any questions or comments, leave them below. That's us done for now, and I will see you in the next one.